In this room full of programmers, I'm wondering if this situation is familiar to anyone. We made a really cool data product. It's really valuable, and we're excited to share it. But then you realize what you've actually made is a fire hose of information. Because much like a talk at a conference, even the most valuable data product can be useless if the delivery isn't catered to your audience. So I was in this situation recently with a geospatial data product that my team developed, and I'm here to tell you how we used Sfarrow for geospatial data to deliver our product in an accessible dashboard. So our cool data product is called Firelytics, and it's a historical database of fire progression in California. So that map up there shows the fire footprint in California just for 2020, which that's pretty scary. That's a lot of land burned in just 1 year. And so I'll circle the largest fire in history, the August fire. And this is a true value of Firelytics. It's a database that holds the spatial progression for every fire that's been satellite detected going back to 2012. So this set of growth polygons exists for all fires on that map, plus 10 more years of data. So Firelytics holds over 22,000 fires and millions of polygons. And this data could be really useful for a variety of audiences. For example, scientists making fire predictive models. We have people working on fuel reduction or evacuation planning. And then we have the general public. Anyone who has been in the path of a wildfire recently might find this interesting. Or my sister actually pointed out this is really useful for hunting for morel mushrooms, which tend to pop up in burn scars. So she was really interested in this. And my team, full of our programmers, our obvious solution to deliver our data to meet the range of everyone here is our shiny dashboard. And our goal for this dashboard is for a user to pick any fire in that historical record and map its progression over time. But generally, spatial data is big and it's slow, and it's not really well suited for a dashboard where users aren't going to sit around and wait for 10 seconds, 20 seconds for data to load. And that's where Sfarrow comes in. The geospatial Sfarrow suite here, it consists of the GeoParquet file format, and we use two R packages, GeoArrow and SFArrow, to help us out. So I'll show you some benchmarks for that 2020 fire data I showed earlier. We saw some savings in memory. The GeoParquet file is a little bit smaller than a shapefile, but what was really impressive to me and my team is the read-in speed, which is less than half that for Sfarrow compared to SF. And this is just the beginning of the time efficiency offered by Sfarrow. If you've used Sfarrow before, all of the functionalities that are available for tabular data are also available for geospatial data. And that includes things like partitioning your data by a grouping variable. Here we partition by fire ID, as well as pre-filtering and pre-aggregating your data before loading it into working memory. So here we use dplyr filter to only load the fire ID number 1 into our working memory out of the whole Firelytics database. And this is really well suited for our dashboard. We can very quickly load very small subsets of Firelytics into our app. So here is someone clicking through the fire progression for that August fire. And each click here runs a pull to the Firelytics database, which is hosted in the cloud as an Sfarrow data set. So this app is actually very light and responsive because only the shape that you see on the map at any given time is loaded into working memory. And the geospatial suite for Sfarrow is relatively new within the past few years, so this is a PSA that it exists, and it's really powerful and impressive. I actually also found it very easy to use. I've been known as a bit of a ding-dong, and I didn't really have much trouble learning it. So next time you find yourself loading geospatial data into R, I really suggest you give it a try. Thank you for listening.